We have on our own launched a service charter, holding ourselves as a government more accountable to its people, ready to raise the bar of service so that our people can live a better life. The balance sheet of this government is not measured by Naira and Kobo. It's not measured by the size of the budget. It is measured by the prosperity, the happiness, and the hope that we see on the faces of the people who choose our state as their homes. We must improve. We must reach for higher heights of excellence and qualitative service delivery. The only reward that we will get for a job well done is more work.
Just like yesterday, the desire and passion of Lagosians to sustain the transformation began since the coming of democracy was rekindled in 2007. By that decision, Mr. Babatunde Rajefashola not only assumed the position of Executive Governor of Lagos State, he also got re-elected for its second term in office in 2011. On Sunday, 18th November 2012, the administration thus reached another landmark as it marks 2,000 days of its coming into government. For the administration and the people, it is a well-known fact that the journey has been both challenging and rewarding. Challenging because of the many issues that have to be dealt with, but rewarding because of the visible achievements that are now part of the repositioning of Lagos as an emerging model mega city. In the last 100 days in particular, Governor Babatunde Rajefashola's administration intensified the implementation of its various policies and projects. These are a combination of security, economic and social oriented programs. They also border on public health and safety. From the security perspective, Babatunde Rajefashola's administration inaugurated another set of equipment for different security formations in the state, comprising 114 patrol vehicles and an array of other gadgets. This is yet another step at strengthening the capacity of security forces to respond to various threats in the state. Along with the existing ones, the new equipment will particularly help to nip in the bud pockets of armed robbery incidents being recorded in some parts of the state and ensure that the already achieved atmosphere of peace needed for progress is sustained. Having achieved considerable mileage in construction of ultra-modern maternal and child care centers, MCCs, across the state, the administration launched the Maternal and Child Mortality Reduction Program. This is a pragmatic step that seeks to effect drastic reduction in percentage number of deaths per mother and child. This will be achieved by providing adequate services before, during, and after childbirth, while infants up to 5 years will receive free medical services.
You see that there is a lot of poverty in our country, in Africa. Africa must begin to slow down its population first so that it can support the ones that are here before adding more to the numbers. That is as simple as my own argument of family planning is. It's a matter of common sense. If you still want to be paying school fees at 76, where you should be enjoying your pension, it is your choice. It is that once we stabilize, especially with our ambassadors, we have already gotten the support of the Association of Private Medical Practitioners to take on this program as a statewide program. So whether you go public or private, you will find this book free. The next project is health insurance. If you put aside 50-50 naira every week, it will add up to 200 naira every month. I assure you that if every family in Lagos State saves 200 naira a month and we put it in an insurance fund, it will cover any type of treatment. Any we have to the glory of God, towards motherhood and childbirth, towards overcoming the challenge of maternal and child mortality in Lagos, Nigeria, and in Africa. It's my honor and pleasure to unveil this booklet.
Under its free health program, a new batch of beneficiaries received free limb deformities corrective surgery. As a socio-economic intervention strategy, the corrective surgery will aid beneficiaries in reducing their dependence on other people. It will allow them move around to fend for themselves. This was particularly confirmed with the personal visit of Governor Babatunde Rajefashola to the beneficiaries and provision of prosthesis and mobility aids.
The work of protecting our citizens, the work of keeping our citizens happy. This is more important for me than building bridges. It's more important for me than building roads. Keeping citizens safe, making them happy, giving them an opportunity to pursue their dreams. The work of protecting our citizens, the work of keeping our citizens happy. This is more important for me than building bridges. It's more important for me than building roads. Keeping citizens safe, making them happy, giving them an opportunity to pursue their dreams. We have set up an Office of Disability. We have enacted a law. We have told all our officers, if you are building any public facility, make sure there is a ramp, make sure there is a lift, make sure there is both. You will see even in our pedestrian bridges now, you have the side that has the step, you have the side that has the ramp. These people, if you give them a chance, we live as competitive a life as you and I have lived.
Years back, this is my picture before. But now, as I'm using it, hardly some people will not even know that I had an accident like this. They will even ask me, what is happening to you? This is your hand. I said, well, I will just laugh. You don't know what is happening. But I thank the governor of Lagos State for giving us, for giving me this hand once again. And I thank the Minister of Health, because I don't know anybody at Minister of Health. I applied to the PharmSec. My application was approved and I was invited by phone. I went there, the measurements, and up to now, I don't even pay cover. I don't even pay city to anybody, and I don't know anybody. I was just applied as a normal citizen of Lagos State, and I was given.
Before this event, I've been taken to various places, spent money and time, but no avail. I was always ashamed of myself. I couldn't walk alone, but people made jests of me, calling me different kinds of names. Some of them are Ayeke, Ebuyeri, Abikoko Nigeria, that is my name is like Nigerian, Nigerian's flag, map. Tekebajeko, say so, and so on. This made it more difficult for me to mix with my peer group. Then the Tekebaje and the news, like Nigerian map, it's not the beautiful girl that is standing before you. Enjoy yourself.
I had an accident when I was at the age of 6, that is in 1978. As a matter of fact, I was in Tramisu. But today I'm an engineer, it's my last time computer engineering. So as many that I am, don't be discouraged. All you need to know, be determined, have a dream for your life. But I want to use this million to thank Lagos State Government. When I was in university, I benefited scholarships for the disabled. And also, I want to express my deep appreciation to my mentor and to a leader who is worthy of emulation. This is a dream come true. Before then, I have been using many prosthetics, facing different challenges. I didn't have anyone. I was able to get one from